ऐसे और वीडियोस के लिए मेरे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें। 3, 2, 1।
मैडम, आई विल बी वेरी ब्रीफ एंड आई शैल नॉट रिपीट सम ऑफ द थिंग्स डैट हैव ऑलरेडी बीन स्टेटेड। आई डू सपोर्ट द मोशन मूव्ड बाय द ऑनरेबल फ्रेंड। एज आई अंडरस्टैंड इट, द अटॉर्नी जनरल व्हेन ही गिव हिज एविडेंस और एडवाइस टू द जॉइंट पार्लियामेंट्री कमेटी बेस्ड his theme on 3 essential points. 1 is that you cannot prove the negative that the non-existence of middleman or agent or whatever despite the fact of the payment of rupees 64 crores as a condition precedent to the contract which he had not actually seen. Therefore, the condition precedent to a contract which he had not examined and which the JPC also had not examined was sufficient ground to say that you can't ask to prove the negative, and thirdly, that condition precedent can also be oral. These were largely the 3 essential points which raise caution, which I believe only the Attorney General can answer, because the legal expert and the Treasury benches would suppress their expertise and would rather come out with partisan aspect of that which is unsustainable. The Attorney General spoke of the Evidence Act. I hold the Evidence Act is essentially a procedure act and a fact-finding committee, such as our joint parliamentary committee was not bound to follow the Evidence Act. There are also exceptions to the Evidence Act, like the principle of the primary burden of proving a fact lying with the party that assert the existence of a thing. And the best example is a child born out of wedlock that is assumed to be the child of that couple, and whoever says that this child is not my child or is not born out of wedlock has to prove it to be so. Here the Evidence Act is asking you to prove the negative. The responsibility of proving the negative lies on whoever makes the assertion. Therefore, the Attorney General is wrong. Therefore, it is necessary that the Attorney General be called here. Finally, I believe there are other constitutional requirements which make it necessary. Here is Article 299 of the Constitution of India, because this is related to the Attorney General giving advice that the condition precedent could be oral. It can be oral in respect of non-government contracts only. Finally, under Section 92, in fact, the Evidence Act excludes oral evidence.